Fine. So next we'll take up convex mirror. Okay. So convex mirrors look like this, right? This is the principal axis, right? Where is the focus? Focus is here, and this is R, okay? And object will be where? This side will be the object. Now there is no F or R here. So there cannot be any cases here. There is just one case, object wherever you keep. Okay? So put an object somewhere and draw its image. Where will be its image? One ray that goes towards the R. What happens to that ray? This will get reflected back because this is along the normal. Right? And one ray that goes like this. What happened to this one? If this is I, it will reflect off like this. This angle will be also I. Right? So where is the image? Will these two ray ever meet? This one and this one? No. But they will appear to meet here. So this is the image. It is real or virtual? It is virtual image. Write down characteristic of image. Characteristics of image. Virtual, diminished, erect. Okay? So if you have been given two virtual images, how will you identify whether this virtual image is from concave or convex? Concave, it will be magnified. Okay? Convex, it will be diminished. Okay? So if I tell you that the size has gone down and it is a virtual image, you don't need to know that. I mean, it should not be mentioned that whether it is convex or concave. You should be able to identify. Okay? One more thing you might have noticed is that whenever the real image gets formed, of course, this mirror will never form a real image. So whenever real image gets formed, it is inverted. Okay? And suppose it is given that the image is put on the screen. So it will not be given, it should not be given that it is having a real image. And if it is a real image, it must be concave mirror. Fine. These all things should be there in your mind. Okay? Now, although we have done almost every case by ray diagram, but it becomes very difficult to exactly locate the location of the image by drawing these, you know, plots, making ray diagrams and things like that. We'll not be able to exactly pinpoint where is the image. Fine. So we should have some sort of formula. Okay. We should have some sort of formula which will output as what is the distance of image. Okay. And what all thing we should already know? We will know that where I am keeping my object. That is easy to measure, isn't it? And I should also know the characteristic of mirror. I should know the focal length of the mirror. Right? So depending on characteristic of mirror and the distance of object from the mirror, I should be able to find out the image distance. There should be some formula, because only these two things, image will depend on characteristic of the mirror and the where is the object. Fine. So now we are getting into the algebra of the chapter, where we will introduce some sort of formula. And this formula, which you already know, it's a mirror formula. Okay. Draw neatly a concave mirror. Slightly bigger will be better. This is the principal axis. This is F. This is R. Okay? Now here is the object. draw its ray diagram. This is a ray diagram. Okay, you will see that the image will lie over here. Okay, now use the naming convention of the points like this. Let's say this is M, this is N, okay, this is O, this is P, this is Q, R, okay, this one was F. Alright, so this is a naming convention. Now I want to find out the distance of, let's go, S, let's say this is T, this point, okay. So I want to find out what is the distance of TP, right? I want to know what is TP. What is given? NP. NP is known. What else is known? Some property of the mirror is also known. What is the property of the mirror? Focal length, right? So focal length is also known. So PF is also known. I want TP in terms of NP and PF. Are you getting it? Now look at it carefully. TP, NP and PF, what are they? They are the distances, horizontal distances along the principal axis. Okay, so you need to bring in these horizontal distances in the equation somehow. Okay, now one easy way to do that is to use similar triangles. Then you can use ratio of sides. Fine. So when you use ratio of sides, one of the side you should take as horizontal. Otherwise, horizontal side will not come in picture. Fine. Other side, don't take this slant one. Other side, take vertical. Why? Because this distance, if you drop perpendicular like this and drop perpendicular from there, okay, these two distances, this distance will be equal to that distance and this distance will be equal to this distance. Fine. So can you judiciously find out what are the two similar triangles where you can involve horizontal distances and vertical distances? Think over it. Tell me, first tell me the similar triangles which you want to involve. Is triangle MNF similar to triangle OPF? Yes or no? Right? And triangle, do it yourself, it will be better. TFS is similar to triangle. No, these two are not similar. PFQ. OFP. Okay. From first condition, what equation will you get? MNF similar to triangle PFQ. What can you write? MN divided by NF. These are two sides of this triangle. This should be equal to what? Do yourself. Try to come up with after this, what should we do? Is left hand side for both same or not? MN is equal to OP and PQ is equal to TS. So left hand sides are same. So I can equate right hand side. So NF by PF is equal to PF by TF. Okay. So PF square is equal to NF multiplied by TF. Fine. I can further write this down as PF square is equal to, what is NF? Is NF known? No. NP PF is known. So what can you write about NF? NF is equal to NP minus PF, right? What is TF? TF is what? TP minus PF. TP is what you have to find out. So it should come in the equation. Otherwise, how will you find out? TP minus PF. Okay? Fine. Mouse. Bus. Is this thing clear? Now, look at it. At times, what will happen if the object is between F and P, image will go that side. Fine. So T will go there. Are you getting it? So if T goes there, the TF will be equal to what? TF will then become equal to FP plus TF. Are you getting it? So this thing will not be valid then. Okay? But if I introduce some sort of sign convention and I say that this side, this the sign is something and that side something else, okay, then automatically sign switching will happen. So this minus will become plus. Are you getting it? Right? So right now we are introducing sign convention before we proceed further. Okay, so write down sign convention. We want to make this formula more generic. It should be applicable for every case. Right now it is applicable only for the case where object and image both are in this side. Okay, write down sign convention. First write down horizontal distances. Horizontal distances. Okay. All the horizontal distances are measured along the principal axis. Horizontal distances are measured along the principal axis. Okay. From pole, all the horizontal distances are measured along the along the principal axis. From pole you measure the distances. Okay. Next point. If starting from pole you go against the direction of incident light, the distances will be negative. The distances will be negative. Fine. Okay. And if you start from pole and go in the direction of incident light, then that distance will be positive. Fine? Clear? Okay. This is about horizontal distances. Now write down vertical distances. About vertical distances. Okay? Vertical distances are measured perpendicular to the principal axis. Fine. Perpendicular to the principal axis. Okay. All right. If one side is positive, the other side will be negative. If one side is positive, the other side is negative. Usually what we do, we take upper one as positive, but upper one is not easy to define. You can't say that what is upper and what is down, but the way you draw it in your notebook, you can define, okay, upper is what or lower is what. So usually you take upper as positive. Okay, so this is the sign convention which we are going to follow. Okay, so now tell me PF. Let us say focal length is F. So PF is what, plus F or minus F? Minus F. So this will be minus F whole square. Why minus F? I am starting from pole along the principle. I am going against the direction of incident ray or not? Incident ray should come from the object. I am going against that. So minus F square. What is NP? NP. Suppose image is V and object is U. NP is what? U. U or minus U? No, you always start from P. So again minus U. What about PF? It is negative. What is TP? TP. It's an image. So minus U. Find minus of minus F. Okay? So F square is equal to F minus U into F minus V. Okay? So you can further simplify this and write down F square is equal to F square minus UF minus VF plus UV. Okay? So you can cut F square like this. Alright? So you will get UF plus VF is equal to UV. Now I can say that this is the mirror formula, but I can make it more concise. How I can make it more concise? By dividing everything by UVF. If you divide everything by UVF, you will get 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. Okay? So this is the mirror formula. Okay? It is valid for all the mirrors. For plane mirror also. For plane mirror, what is focal length? Infinity. When you put F equal to infinity, this term becomes 0. So you get V is equal to minus U. That's how it should be. Okay? So this is the mirror formula derivation. There are approximations here. Right, there are few approximations. You take an aperture less, you know, and you take an R is equal to F by 2. So all that approximation we have taken here. Okay. Any doubt on this? This is about horizontal distances. What about vertical distance? Vertical distance will tell you how much image has magnified. Okay, so let us see that. In order to do that, you should make a construction in the ray diagram. Draw a light like this, light ray. This will reflect off and will again meet at the same point, isn't it? Like this. Fine. So this is suppose height of object and this suppose is height of image. Okay? Fine. So, if you look at it carefully, triangle MNP is similar to triangle TPS. Fine? So, I can say that MN by NP is equal to TS by TP. Getting it? Right? MN is what? MN is, use sign convention, okay? If you're taking MN as plus H naught, you're saying that upward is positive. Fine. So MN is plus H naught. NP is what? Minus U. Fine. TS minus HI. Right, TP minus V. Fine. So HI by HO is equal to minus V by U. Okay. This is what the magnification is. Fine. So we have magnification formula. Right. So we have talked about horizontal distances and now vertical distances also. So I can exactly find out what, you know, how the image will be and where it will be.